All right, so you've made commits. You understand that a commit ID is a big deal. And now we're going to talk about a two-step commit, why you have to use git add and git commit. Now remember, when we make a commit ID, that is pretty permanent, right? That's in history. So this section over here is our log of commits. It's like a story of all of the changes you've made to put together your code base. But first we have to get there, right? So you're working locally, you make some changes. Say you make changes to an index.html and to a CSS file. But you don't really want those to be stored together. The changes that you made were not logically related in any way. That's okay. That's what git add is for. Git lets you choose exactly which files you want to include in the next commit. So let's say we want to do the index first. So we'll git add index.html, and it'll move that file in git's metadata to the staging area. Git knows that when you run git commit, only to include the index file, not the CSS file. So any files in the working directory, if you want them to be included in the commit, you need to use git add first. Once they're in the staging area, Git's going to include them in the next commit once you run git commit. And then all of those files, that snapshot of the repository, including your changes, are stored with that 40-character SHA-1 hash in history.